using conjugates to find limits. So here I have the limit is x squared to 7 of square root of x plus 9 minus 4 over x minus 7. Clearly a 0 over 0 type of limit. If you plug in 7 for x, you get 0 on top and 0 on the bottom. And we're going to multiply by the conjugate. So when we see the conjugate, we really, I mean, the conjugate can be a little bit misleading, I suppose. So the conjugate of x minus 7 is x plus 7. The conjugate of this minus this is this plus this. Specifically, when you multiply by the conjugate, you usually multiply by the conjugate of the square root part. So I'm going to multiply by the square root of x plus 9 plus 4 over the same thing, right? Because we're only allowed to multiply by 1. So this and this and these are both conjugates of each other. And the reason we multiply by a conjugate, so the conjugate of a minus b is a plus b and vice versa. And when you multiply conjugates together, you get the first thing squared minus the second thing squared because the middle terms cancel out, right? It's a squared plus ab minus ab, those cancel, minus b squared. So that's why we're doing this. And the reason we're doing that specifically is so that we get the square root squaring out. So I end up with the limit as x goes to 7 of the square root of x plus 9 squared, so just x plus 9. I'm actually going to write the middle terms to show you they cancel. So I get this times 4. I get this times negative 4. Oh, hey, those cancel. And the negative 4 times negative 4 is minus 16. Or as I think of it, square root of x plus 9 squared minus 4 squared. All over. On the bottom, you don't multiply it out. Because we're looking to make this x minus 7 cancel out. Simplifying. The limit as x goes to 7. On top, I get x plus 9 minus 16, which is x minus 7. On the bottom, I get x minus 7. The bottom doesn't change. This x minus 7 and this x minus 7 cancel, leaving a 1 on top. So I get the limit as x goes to 7 of 1 over square root of x plus 9 plus 4. And then we plug in the 7, and we get 1 over the square root of 7 plus 9 plus 4, which is 1 over the square root of 16 plus 4, and 4 plus 4 is 8. Another example. Limit as x goes to negative 2 of x plus 2 over the square root of x plus 6 plus x. Again, 0 over 0 type. If I plug in negative 2, I get 0. If I plug in negative 2, I get square root of 4 is 2 plus negative 2 is 0. So we're going to multiply by the conjugate. And again, I'm not going to multiply by x minus 2, even though it is the conjugate of x plus 2. I'm multiplying by the conjugate of the square root thing. So the conjugate of this plus this is this minus this. So we multiply by the square root of x plus 6 minus x. Same thing on top and bottom. And again, the things that aren't actually conjugates, this and this, we don't multiply out. We just say it's x plus 2 times the square root of x plus 6 minus x. Because again, we're looking to make this x plus 2 cancel. The bottom, so again, this times its own conjugate is just the first piece squared, which is just x plus 6, minus the second piece squared, and x times x is just x squared. Did I miss something? Nope. Okay. And so then, simplifying a bit, you get the limit as x goes to minus 2 of x plus 2 on top times square root of x plus 6 minus x. On the bottom, I'm going to do this over on the side just so I don't run out of room here. So on the bottom, I have negative x squared plus x plus 6. Which does factor, but I'm terrible at factoring ones like this. So I'm going to actually factor out the minus 1 first. I'm left with x squared minus x minus 6. And then that factors as x minus 3 times x plus 2. Right? Because x squared minus 3x plus 2x is minus x. And minus 3 plus 2 is minus 6. So this denominator factors exactly that way. Negative 1 times x minus 3 times x plus 2. I also could have made a good guess that x plus 2 was going to factor out because I need that to cancel. So this x plus 2 cancels with that. Then we're left with the limit as x goes to negative 2 of the square root of x plus 6 minus x all over negative 1 times x minus 3. Plugging in negative 2, I get the square root of negative 2 plus 6 is 4. Minus negative 2 all over negative 1 times negative 2 minus 3. So I end up with, let's see, 2 plus 2, so 4 on top. And negative 1 times negative 5 is positive 5 on the bottom. So I get 4/5.